starter in this game. And he'll have two shots. 75% for the year. Perfect on the first.
Well, and he's coming off, as you mentioned earlier, Greg, his career high against Baylor Sunday in the conference opener when he had 17 points and 5 3-point baskets.
Statistically, he's the best foul shooter with one exception. Sid Harris has not missed, but Sid's only shot 7. Potts is back in. Buckman is out. Buckman's been struggling. He has not scored. He averages 12 points a game, a couple of fouls. He does have a couple of rebounds. Aldridge, the top rebounder, along with Tucker. Tucker, the top rebounder on the court, with 5.
Easy.
Law dumps it in to Walker. The Walker does not have the height advantage, so he backs it out. Minute and a half to go in the first half. 32-20 in favor of the Aggies. Leach cuts loose with a 3 and hits it.
Billy Gillespie very happy with the way Leach has come along this year. He's become a clutch performer, very tough defensively, and a hard-nosed youngster.
Double team on Polino to take the away. They're going to call a kick. Actually, that was a tough break for the Aggies, the kick being called because they had a break.
Well, that's the second time Polino has not handled the double team. Texas A&M wisely changing their defense with Polino at the point. And you're going to see the kick. And as you mentioned, Texas A&M had a clean break to the basket. Nobody anywhere near AC Law.
And he shows his frustration when he heard that whistle. A minute to go in the first half. And it goes off the hands of Kirk. Out of bounds. It'll be back to the Longhorns now. 59 seconds in the half. 35 on the shot clock. And the Aggies will bring Edwan Green back into the game. They'll also bring in Kenneth White.
Watch big Edwan Green now. He was the second leading rebounder in the nation in the junior college ranks last year at Temple, J.C. Billy Gillespie's expecting a lot out of him.
Paulino. The team footer, Paulino. Nice. They're just letting him have the ball and do it.
Yeah, nice job by Paulino. By far the most effective Longhorn offensively here, other than Tucker in the first half.
That could be an end up being a 2-for-1 because the shot clock's 24, 30 seconds to go in the period. So because he got that shot up when he did, Texas may get one more possession. Well, they're definitely going to get it because away from the basketball, we have a violation. It's going to be going on Pompey.
That's his second offensive foul of the night. He's moving on those screens. You cannot do that.
And his fourth of the game already.
Well, Texas A&M is a team with not great depth inside, so that's certainly crucial. You've got to be smarter than that, especially with the seconds ticking down.
Well, Texas has a chance for the final 4 points of the half. 35-22, 18 seconds to play. And now P.J. Tucker is moving it back outside, 12 seconds. And well, now here's a guy you ought to go against because Pompey is going to defend him, but he's got 4 fouls. And he's going to go against him. And he's going to spin in, and there's a whistle, a shirt grab. Again, the third foul called on the Aggies for grabbing shirts. And it's number 5. Pompey's done.
Well, that's incredible to have a player that was helping you as much as Pompey was helping the Aggies and get called here. That was a good strategy by Rick Barnes in Texas to go right at him. Nobody better to do it with than P.J. Tucker.
Well, he's done with 2 seconds to go in the first half. Jones, of course, has had a lot of time off. He's going to come back in here for 2 seconds.
Well, Greg, this is really unbelievable. The Aggies could have this margin right now, and they have 16 team fouls in the first half. That's just an incredible stat.
It is, but as I pointed out earlier, they do foul a lot.
They do foul a lot, and Texas was shooting it all. The game obviously would not be like it is right now with one team having 16 fouls. Texas shooting 21% for the first half of action.
He misses them both. And he may have fouled going in for the rebound. And he did.
Well,
and he's got a couple.
I'm not sure I've ever seen a game where there's been 27 fouls called in the first half. This is just uncanny.
Leach will shoot the free throws. He'll have two.
We might get off the air by midnight.
Well, yeah, after you factor the great rally and the fact the game goes to overtime before one of these two teams wins it. Although, tell you what, the Aggies are playing the way they're playing. It isn't going to go there. More for Leach.
Well, the biggest thing the Aggies have going for them is they've got this large margin, and their leading scorer hadn't even scored. And Joe Jones has actually played very little.
Of course, on the Texas side, they can say we're behind, but about five of our guys have scored. All right, 37-22. A&M calls a timeout with 1 second, or just under 2 seconds left. 25-10 run. Hey, Thursday, Pac-10 College Hoops returns to FSN with a doubleheader beginning with the UCLA Bruins battling Arizona State. And Oregon State takes on Washington State. Coverage begins Thursday at 7:30 Central only on FSN Southwest.
Greg, yeah. We said it was going to be a rough game before it ever started, and it is certainly filling that bill. Lots of stoppages of action because of fouling and rough play, but that's the nature of both of these teams, hard-nosed and rough.
Well, AC Law has been able to rise above it, and so has P.J. Tucker. They are the top two scorers. Tucker with 10, but he's missed four free throws. AC Law has not taken a free throw. He's got 5 2-pointers and a three. 13. And now we'll see what the Texas 1.7 second play is. I don't think it's going to work. Leach from midcourt, and it's over to the left, and we've reached the end of the first half. The Aggie fans are giving their heroes quite a rousing reception as they head toward the locker room. At halftime, it's 37 for Texas A&M. And only 22 for the 10th-ranked Texas Longhorns. We'll be back with our activities at halftime. Visit with Billy Gillespie will be part of our halftime, but we'll be back in a moment.
What up, Jerry and Phil?
Hey, Al, can we borrow your car?
Jerry and Phil, Jerry and Phil, Jerry and Phil in your automobile.
Will they damage your car?
Of course they will. It's Terry.
It's Terry and Phil.
The Roommates, coming this fall.
You know what?
You don't trust just anyone with your car. Why trust any company to insure it? Step up to State Farm. See your local Texas State Farm agent for good coverage at a good price.
From the fastest and strongest to the most capable and most powerful Dodge Ram trucks. Matched by none, envied by all.
Come on, man, floor it!
Now get 0+. That means 0% financing, plus great package discounts, plus bonus cash for total savings up to $9,100.
Totally Football is your source for all pro and college gridiron news.
The hardest hitting football show in the biz.
Weeknights on FSN.
So, Jane, resume looks great. What are you most proud of?
Well, I spent 4 years tracking a gang of international bank robbers until I finally busted them just outside of Tokyo. That was awesome.
Great.
Experience TV so compelling, you'll swear you're there. Crack the case with Interpol, the world's largest crime-fighting force. Take down the most wanted villains. Interpol investigates Tuesdays on the National Geographic Channel. Check local listings.
You love football, so do we. Fox Football Friday.
Yay!
This Friday, we go around the leagues to see what's hot and preview the top games for the weekend.
You need to know, we'll tell you.
Well, I say what, second is not good enough.
Ooh, that's not nice.
Previews, predictions, and much, much more right here on Fox Football Friday.
Get over there and compete for a spot.
Yes!
This show does not work unless you get involved.
Fox Football Friday, only on Fox Sports World, America's soccer channel.
We're in great shape.
You're watching FSN Southwest.
This is a Southwest Sports Report update.
Hello, Hoops fans. Welcome into the FSN Southwest studios. I'm Dana Larson. We'll get you back out to the game in just a bit, but first I want to introduce you to a future Aggie star. or future Longhorn star. Martellus Bennett of A-Leaf Taylor is one of those players we will definitely be talking about in the future. With which team, we don't know yet. Will he be playing basketball as well? That's another question. But one thing's for sure, Martellus Bennett, beyond his athleticism, has all the makings of a big-time star. Here's Dave Scallon.
A-Leaf Taylor's Martellus Bennett loves three things. Football, where he's listed by Rivals.com as the number one tight end recruit in the entire country. Basketball, where he's listed by TexasHoops.com as a top 10 college prospect.
Martellus Bennett drank Gatorade. Why don't you?
But perhaps most of all, Martellus Bennett loves the spotlight.
Thanks.
With a personality like this to go along with his athletic ability, it's easy to see Martellus is going places. The only question most college coaches are asking is where, and also which sport.
Some basketball coaches told me that they wouldn't mind if I just play basketball, but if I want to play both, I guess because both, I won't be on a basketball scholarship, so they still have another scholarship to give out, so I guess they don't really bother them like that.
Our district has turned out a lot of really good athletes and a lot of Division I college, you know, athletes, but we've never had an athlete in our district do what Martellus has done. Play 5A varsity football and play 5A varsity basketball, much less play at the level he's played at.
It's because of that high level of play at two very high profile sports that Martellus has his hands full, not only trying to pick a college, but also pick a sport.
It's not 5A high school basketball and football you're trying to put together. You're playing Division I basketball and football at the very highest level, and that's difficult. And he just, you know, we try to make him aware of the reality of it. But he's a very confident young man, and I think he wants to try that. And I think he's well aware that it may be a couple years, and he may have to say, hey, I'm going to do this or I'm going to do that. And I think he's realistic enough to understand that.
It's fun playing both. It's exciting. I just look for another chance to compete. Whenever I get a chance to compete, I'm just going to go out there and play. I'll play golf, tennis. I'll probably play baseball this year, too.
You're going to play baseball this year?
Most likely, but...
Just something to help you stay in shape? Or?
Yeah, I'm going to work out, but just to get out there and play against other competition will be fun.
And want to find out from the horse's mouth where he's headed? Check out our Southwest Recruiting Show. It's Inside Southwest Recruiting with Rivals.com's Bobby Burton and myself every Tuesday until National Signing Day at 6:30. Speaking of recruiting, we will talk recruiting coming up after the game on your Busch Light Southwest Sports Report. We'll update the Aggies recruiting class. We'll also hear from one of UT's all-time favorite recruits, former Longhorn and current Detroit Lion, Roy Williams. And, of course, we will have all of your A&M and Texas postgame. Well, that will do it for us here in the studios. It's time now for more hoops, a quick break, and it's back to the arena. Enjoy the second half, everyone. We'll see you right here after the game.
Dallas, Texas, August 10th, 1945. Nurses are forced to subtract 28.5 ounces from the birth weight of Gary Blair because they cannot pry the regulation-sized basketball out of his hands. Grayford, Texas, November 23rd, 1967. Billy Gillespie is forced by his homeroom teacher to write, "I will not make my classmates run wind sprints for not playing aggressive defense at recess 300 times on a blackboard."
The 265-horsepower Acura MDX gets hearts in the right place, even if you're not.
Ta-da. Oh.
Why does technology have to be so difficult? At CompUSA, we make technology easy. Easy to get, easy to use. CompUSA, you're on.
The 2005 Accord from Honda. When you consider the Accord was rated the best overall value in its class, and given the fact it also has the lowest depreciation in its class, then there's really only one thing left to say. Our sentiments exactly. The spacious and affordable 2005 Accord from Honda.
For the record, a fan's love of the race has no finish line. Busch Beer. For 23 years running, proud sponsor of the NASCAR Busch Series.
Rams, Falcons, Vikings, Eagles. The NFC Divisional Playoffs in HD on Fox.
This is the State Farm Lone Star Showdown in College Station. The Aggies lead it 37-32 before a full house at Reed Arena. Well, there's a new coach in town this year, Billy Gillespie, and one of the things that he believes is crucial to this program continuing to draw these full houses is a commitment to success.
Well, I think every other sport on campus has done that, and so I don't know why they should expect anything different from us. But what we have to do is, no matter what the building is like or whatever, if you get good players that play the game the right way, then you're going to have a chance. People are going to, there's so many former students, there's so many students here, they're definitely going to support the program, and so I think we're on the right track. Well, I'm awfully proud. That's the thing we wanted to establish this year, is a work ethic, and, you know, we had so many new guys that had not been on this, a college campus quite like Texas A&M before, and so we definitely wanted to establish a work ethic, and I think we're on the way to getting that done. I think it'll bode well for us in the future. It's pretty shocking. You know, it's about like playing in the Big 12 on a nightly basis. It's a shock, and you don't know how tough it's going to be until you really do it. And they've accepted things very, very well. I love my team, the intangibles that they possess, and I think they're continuing to grow into a really nice team. You have to recruit well, and as much as you like to think that so many things make a difference, the number one thing, in my opinion, is recruiting really, really, really good players, and we should be able to do that at a university like A&M. I look forward to the challenge. I have a great deal of admiration for how they've gone about building their program to a national power, and we've seen a lot of those guys throughout the years, and I love what Coach Barnes and his staff have done, and they're a national player every year. They're a team that's capable of going to the Final Four every year, and we're going to try to emulate what they've done with their program and try to get to that point someday.
Well, that's the way he coaches. There's no I in Billy Gillespie. His team so far on top by 15 at the intermission. Jim and I'll be back in a moment.
Dallas, Texas, August 10th, 1945. Nurses are forced to subtract 28.5 ounces from the birth weight of Gary Blair because they cannot get the regulation-sized basketball out of his hands. Grayford, Texas, November 23rd, 1967. Billy Gillespie is forced by his homeroom teacher to write, "I will not make my classmates run wind sprints for not playing aggressive defense at recess 300 times on a blackboard."
When designing the all-new Ford 500, we raised more than just the bar. We also elevated the seats to give you a more commanding view of the road. We boosted performance to give you heightened responsiveness. And we lifted the standard of safety, earning 5-star ratings for driver and passenger in front and side impact. In fact, on the Ford 500, we raised everything except the price. Ford is the best in Texas.
We bought a Chaps designer suit at a department store for $329.99. At K&G, they're less than half that. K&G, for men, for less.
Poncho's Piping Hot Sopapillas and Honey are free every day. Poncho's, fresh handmade Mexican food, great prices, and family fun.
You're ready for a little more Poncho Mexican buffet.
Come hungry.
I'm Brad, and I was just wondering...
Brad, I sense someone great hidden inside of you. Who is that person, Brad? You don't have to be trapped in the prison of your body. Imagine yourself with no limitations. Don't allow your weight to hold you back.
But I'm not fat.
Now that is the power of fuel.
Fox Movie Channel is the first and only network that brings you your favorite movies direct from the source, 20th Century Fox.
Showtime.
Our vast library contains some of the greatest films of all time.
Do you read me?
All uncut and commercial free.
I'll be back.
As well as today's top stars.
Wait a minute.
Plus, original programming only we can deliver.
You're watching Fox Movie Channel.
It's all here on Fox Movie Channel.
You're watching FSN Southwest.
Aggies lead it by 15. You see there, Daniel Gibson is stitched and taped. We will see him in the second half. Longhorns certainly need him, but let's take a look at some of the highlights in the first half, Jim.
Well, certainly it's going to be mostly Texas Aggie highlights because that's the way the first half is gone. Brad Buckman on the early miss, but the freshman LaMarcus Aldridge on the putback. But here come the Aggies starting to establish their 15-point advantage. Bobby Leach on the layup. Right there, the freshman Joe Jones making the nice spin move to the rack. And Daniel Gibson hitting one of only two threes for the Texas Longhorns in the first half. And P.J. Tucker, their most reliable player, he leads the way with 10 because of buckets like that in the paint. And A.C. Law, he's been the star of the first half. 13 points and 5 assists. A.C. Law has been absolutely fantastic.
Well, his team is leading by 15. The second half is next. We'll be right back.
CarMax.com makes car shopping quick and easy. With actual prices, photos, and details on over 20,000 cars nationwide, you can search for cars without missing a play. CarMax, the way car buying should be.
CarMax thinks you should have lots of choices when shopping for a used car. We have 10 times more cars than the average dealer, so it's easy to find the car that's right for you. In fact, we've sold over 1 million cars since opening our doors. CarMax, the way car buying should be.
You know that feeling you get when you could have ordered your burger with extra onions, grilled jalapenos, and 3 slices of cheese? But you didn't, and your buddy did? That's what we call getting out Whataburgered.
What a burger!
Just like you like it.
Hey.
Oh, sorry.
Quit it.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
I'm working here.
Oh, yeah, working. Hello? Yeah, it's for you.
Thank you.
Why does technology have to be so difficult? At CompUSA, we make technology easy. Easy to get, easy to use. CompUSA, you're on.
Billy Gillespie has to be happy with that scoreboard, but he also is a coach who knows they've got 20 more minutes to play, and Rick Barnes certainly knows that. He also, I'm sure, had some strong constructive criticism of his team in the locker room. We'll see what happens.
I think Texas, you're being a little light in the way you're describing that, my man.
Gibson back.
I think there was a whole lot of hollering going on in that UT locker room.
Buckman tries the muscle, can't get it in. Rebound to Jones. Jones had 6 rebounds in the first half, so he's the top rebounder in the game with 7.
Yeah, and Jones only played 10 minutes of the first half. The guy with the ball, the Aggies' leading scorer, only played 5 minutes.
Kirk misses the 3, and Aldridge gets the rebound. He had just 2 points in the first half, 37-22. In fact, you go through most of the Longhorns, and they didn't score many points. Buckman had none. He's double-teamed. Gathering himself, has to give it up to Gibson for the 3. And he is just ice cold before the injury and even now after, as he holds on to the loose ball, goes baseline, tries to shove it in, and Jones with a steal and a tie ball. Let's quickly take a look at the halftime stats. The ball's going to go over to our left. Field goal percentage, Texas, not there. The Aggies very good, and of course the Aggies fouled a lot, but didn't hurt them.
Well, free throw shooting, Texas 6 out of 14. Things have just not gone right for the Longhorns at all. 21% field goal shooting, I'm sure, is the most horrible percentage they've had in years. But Texas A&M, remember, leads the Big 12 Conference in defense, allowing their opponents only 57 points per game. Longhorns, of course, have 22 here at the half.
An interesting point about the Aggies is that their early season schedule, let's say their first 8 or 9 games, was not strong.
Well, when they beat the University of Houston here, that opened some eyes, and then they go to Penn State and win on the road, and then go to Lawrence, Kansas, and play the nation's number 2 team even.
Which shot shows chart. They were going. There's the P.J. Tucker shot chart. They say he just had 5. Those 3 that he missed, that was in extreme traffic down there in the bottom.
Well, P.J. Tucker is always going to get most of his in the paint. He knows how to maneuver in there. Very smart. Texas coming out in a 2-3 zone. Aggies were patient against it in the first half. A.C. Law was able to penetrate against it at will.
How about that? Law with a quick fake.
That's the key against the zone, Greg. The Aggies were patient. Law's got his confidence going. Made the quick move into the head of the circle. Knocked it down.
17-point lead. Buckman to the baseline. That'll be an offensive foul. He just rammed in to Wright.
Well, both teams in obvious foul trouble. We see Buckman picking up his 4th foul there. Antoine Wright, what did I tell you before the game? He has become a much more complete player. Poor on the defensive end as a freshman and sophomore. Billy Gillespie loves the way he's playing this season.
Walker gives it up. A.C. Law. Wright has no shot. Gets it back out to Kirk. Law. Walker around the right on top now. He's being guarded by P.J. Tucker. And he backs it away. 12 on the shot clock.
Well, this is the Aggies' original starting lineup on the floor now.
Wright with a banger. Oh, what a move by Wright. That was just a one-on-one play, and Wright wins the battle.
Well, he's a terrific one-on-one talent. Greg, there's 10 NBA scouts here tonight. Most of them here to see that young man, even though he's just a junior.
Gibson with a long 3, and he is just super cold. 1 for 8. Gibson over to Tucker. Clocks backing over, using his height. Can't get the shot to fall. And Jones with the rebound. Major height advantage for Klotz there as Walker was on him. He couldn't get it up. And meanwhile, there's a foul trying to squeeze through the defense. Law is fouled.
Let's watch Antoine Wright now with his move into the paint, going one-on-one against a very good Longhorn defense. When you do this against P.J. Tucker, you've done something special. That's what Antoine Wright just did.
Antoine Wright doesn't get that one down. Tucker with a rebound. Brings it down the court, flips it over to Klotz, and Klotz is fouled as he goes up with a shot.
That's a foul, I believe. Is that on Dominique Kirk? Let's see. Yeah, Kelly Self.
No,
oh, Antoine
one.
Wright. Good gracious, that's his 3rd foul. Only played 5 minutes in the first half. Good job of running the floor by Jason Klotz. Look at the big fella getting it down the floor. Nice job.
2 shots for Klotz. Yeah, one more. That's his 1st point of the game. Klotz has been a double-figure regular this year, but he has only got 1 point in this game.
Well, Texas is now 8 for 16 at the free throw line. Not good enough to win on the road, that's for sure. But lots of time left. This Longhorn team is tough, tough, tough. Let's see if they can make it happen. They're playing against a tough, tough team, though, in the Texas Aggies here.
And right with 3. Well, the thing the Longhorns are also going to face is a team that's getting more and more confidence with every minute. Tucker goes into traffic. Another offensive foul. He was set up for the penetration.
Well, Texas A&M's putting on a clinic defensively here tonight. In all the right places at the right time. They've drawn many charges because they are going to the right place when they're supposed to. Watch this one. Dominique Kirk, the freshman, drawing his 2nd charge of the night. Antoine Wright had just drawn his 1st moments ago.
It's a 20-point Aggie lead.
Well, the Aggies' last basket was a three-pointer by Antoine Wright. Coming into this game, he had made 11 out of his last 22 three-point attempts over the last four games.
Kirk to Jones. Jones tries to dribble through too many people, but he picks it up anyway, and he's fouled.
Now, he was a little bit lucky there because he did try to dribble through too many people, but his hustle got him the ball back, and he draws the foul.
Well, Joe Jones had five first-half points. He's got that big wide body and he knows how to maneuver.
At the line of the Aggies, number three, Joseph Jones, shooting two.
I said it earlier, but he's certainly been the surprise not only of Texas A&M basketball, but probably in the entire league. The contribution he has made to this team. He had 23 earlier this year against the University of Houston.
Well, he certainly has the body for it. He's got some weight on him, about 260 at 6'9". One out of two, 45. The 24, 21-point Aggie lead. They lead. Their lead at the half is 15, and it's gotten bigger. Tucker.
Well, I just can't say enough about
Gibson. Still, just not his game. All he's getting is threes, and he's missing them all. We got a timeout. The crowd is into it. 15:47 to play, and the Aggies lead the Longhorns 45 to 24.
Dallas, Texas, August 10th, 1945. Nurses are forced to subtract 28.5 ounces from the birth weight of Gary Blair because they cannot pry the regulation-sized basketball out of his hands. Grayford, Texas, November 23rd, 1967. Billy Gillespie is forced by his homeroom teacher to write, "I will not make my classmates run wind sprints for not playing aggressive defense at recess 300 times on a blackboard."
Dodge Durango's making it to the top of a lot of lists. He came in first in a Car and Driver full-size SUV comparison test. It received 5 stars, the highest government frontal crash test rating. And since it's roomier and more powerful than Explorer or Trailblazer, lots of American families are making Durango their first choice. See your Dodge dealer and put Durango at the top of your list, too. Now get 0+. That means 0% financing plus a great package discount plus bonus cash for total savings up to $88.50. At a department store, you can get an elegant 100% wool suit for $299.99. K&G has 100% wool suits that look just as stylish for a third of that. Really. K&G has incredible savings on a wide range of fashions 7 days a week. K&G Fashion Superstore. For men, for less.
Aggies by 21. Hey, you know, the high school football season may be over, but the recruiting season has just begun. Find out what star players your college is going to recruit for the next year's Inside Recruiting. Inside Southwest Recruiting. Join Rivals.com expert Bobby Burton and the FSN Southwest crew as they break down who's going where. You can get the inside scoop first on Inside Southwest Recruiting Tuesday at 6:30 on FSN Southwest. Well, both coaches here admit that recruiting is a key to succeeding in your programs. Both have recruited well. And the Aggies are opening a lot of eyes with the way they're playing right now. Texas has no field goals yet in the second half. And we've played almost 5 minutes.
This is a good maneuver by the Longhorns going to their 2-2-1 half-court trapping defense. Trying to change the rhythm, get the Aggies out of their comfortable tempo.
14 on the shot clock. Wright breaks loose at the top of the screen. He's going to move on Tucker, dump it across the way. Back out to Law for three. Front rim, back rim, and that may not count. That, wait a minute.
I think they're calling Joe Jones on the back Longhorns. The basket is no good. And
don't think it would have counted anyway.
The Aggie calls, that's his third foul. There's a lot of basketball yet to be played. 15 minutes to go, and Joe Jones has three fouls, and Antoine Wright has three.
Watts can't make it inside. Taylor, they've not allowed him any open threes, but he goes inside and gets a two. And Taylor has his first 2 points. This is a very strange game. Leafs travel. Turns it back the other way. Taylor has 2 points. And by the way, the first field goal of the second half for Texas. Taylor has only 2 points in the game. Aldridge only 2 points in the game. Gibson only 3 points in the game.
Buckman, no points. 12 points, now 14 points. All the starters have scored, and the bench has only scored 9.
Well, when you go 5 minutes to start the second half without a bucket when you're down by 15 to start with, that's
a push
not
off
a good sign.
Oh, that's a foul on Law, push-off. Team foul 3, second on Law. Texas inbounds. D.J. Tucker, 10 points, 5 rebounds in the first half. Playing with 3 fouls. Ball goes into Aldridge, has to come back out. The swing around to Taylor. Well, he had nothing. Aldridge back out to Taylor. May have a 3-second call. We do. 3-second violation.
Nice defense right there once again by Antoine Wright. I don't want to overdo this, but he's never been a good on-ball defender. He's had lots of raves around the league because of his scoring. But he is a changed man under the direction of Billy Gillespie this season.
Under the basket, the ball is thrown out to right. He fakes the shot. Leach at the point.
Nice ball movement by Texas A&M against the Longhorns trapping defense. Edwan Green, not a threat out front at all. You can see how far Texas backs off of him.
Right, maybe one-on-one on Gibson, and Gibson with a takeaway. He just picked his pocket. Gibson comes back down court. He's going to challenge, and he has had it blocked by Jones. And taken by Jones. And Leach. Leach's limp leg pass off to Law for 3. Got it.
That's where the Aggies want to go. He's the guy with the hot hand. 18 points now here for the sophomore lefty.
22-point lead for Texas A&M. Tucker. Taylor for 3. Got it.
Now Kenny Taylor gets warmed up. You better watch that senior, one of 3 seniors on the Texas ball club. He's coming off of his first rough game of the year, only made 2 out of 10 against Baylor in the conference opener Sunday.
A.C. Law guarded by Gibson. Off the dribble. Not much there. That was a bad pass.
Good defense by the Longhorn freshman right there, LaMarcus Aldridge. Got to be impressed with that.
Tucker to the basket, can't get it down. The rebound to Klotz. Klotz will try to use his height over the top of Green. Klotz. Jason Klotz with 4.
Yeah, he did a good job of backing his way into the paint there and just shooting over the Aggie defense.
And we got a 30-second timeout being called here.
Looks like A.C. Law is favoring an ankle or a knee.
Yeah, he's holding it. He's walking on tiptoe on his right leg. Don't forget, ACC Sunday Night Hoops returns to FSN this week with a doubleheader beginning with the 8th-ranked Georgia Tech Bulldogs taking on North Carolina State. And Virginia battles 5th-ranked Duke. Coverage begins with a tip-off show at 4 p.m. Central only on FSN Southwest. Yeah, let's see where he does. Maybe a cramp, too. That's also a possibility because of the way he was on one toe.
Well, this will put Bobby Leach at the point for the Aggies. Let's see how much pressure the Longhorns can apply to him.
Looks like he's getting a massage of the calf. He may have had a calf cramp, but we'll see. Meanwhile, Leach with the basketball on the point. Drives down the lane. Left-hand spin. Can't get enough spin. It's knocked out of bounds. It will still be the Aggies basketball.
Nice recognition by Leach to see the crack in the Longhorn defense. Took it all the way. Now, Greg, what's so shocking about Texas' performance so far here tonight is they have the best record in the Big 12 Conference over the last 6 years on the road. They've won 33 ball games and only lost 15 in the last 6 years on the road.
Well, and as good as we know they are, that means it's time to give this Aggie team a lot of credit because they really came to play, and this team is getting better with every game out. It also shows that 5-point loss at Kansas was absolutely no fluke. Well, the game was that close.
Yeah, and remember the game was tied with just a moment, 1 minute to go in the contest. So this will strike some fear into the hearts of some Big 12 opponents that weren't quite sure how good the Aggies were.
Right for 3, that's way off. And the rebound taken down by Tucker. P.J. Tucker leads it up court. Aldridge. Jump hook, Aldridge.
Well, that's 2 straight inside buckets blitzed by the Longhorns. That's where they need to go. They've cut it now to 15. There's still about 12 minutes to go in this game. It could turn quickly after the Aggies enjoyed a 22-point advantage. If AC Law can't come back, it could be tough on the Aggies.
Well, it really is going to be up. You mentioned the offense, but actually the Texas defense is a key, too. Wright is cut off because the defense will allow them to gain instead of just for the basketball. He's going to go over the top with a three, and that's not going to go. Long rebound to Klotz. Now Texas can turn two more off the score, maybe three more. Polino sneaks it inside Aldridge and a holding foul.
Now got Edwan Green holding Aldridge down on the block. I like what Texas is doing now, emphasizing getting the ball where they've really got the size advantage.
Now we got a break with 11:04 to go in the game. It's 48-32.
What up, Jerry and Phil?
Hey, Al, can we borrow your car?
Jerry and Phil in your automobile.
Will they damage your car?
Of course they will.
It's Jerry and Phil.
Roommates coming this fall.
You know what? I'll drive.
Trust just anyone with your car. Why trust any company to insure it? Step up to State Farm. See your local Texas State Farm agent for good coverage at a good price.
Meet Bob. Bob went to Nebraska, and their other friend, Florida State. Now they all live together in L.A. So how do they follow their favorite college teams? With Fox College Sports, featuring over 800 NCAA games each year on three regionally aligned channels, FCS Pacific, FCS Central, and FCS Atlantic. All the games that matter in one powerful package. To order Fox College Sports, 72 get FCS. Fox College Sports, where college never ends.
Uh-huh. Well, I'm sure she didn't mean it. Man, that's tough. Jerry, look, I have to run. There's this oil field on fire. Huge flames. Yeah, we have to get out there. Jerry, I gotta go.
Experience adventure so real. Feel like you're there. From storm shooters to smoke jumpers. Work never looked so wild. Dangerous Jobs. Wednesdays on the National Geographic Channel.
You're watching FSN Southwest.
This game before a sellout crowd, an Aggie 15-point lead is really unusual. Here's why. Look at what Texas has done this year.
Well, we've said repeatedly, Texas is the leading scoring team in the Big 12 Conference. Only here tonight with 11 minutes to go. The cause of that? 24% field goal accuracy for the game, and what they depend on so much is their outside perimeter, the three-point ball in particular. Tonight only shooting 23% from out there.
And consider that Texas has lost two games by a total of 3 points so far. The Aggies have lost one game by five. It's 48-33 with 11 minutes to go. Trying to drive through the lane. Jones ties up Polino, and the arrow will keep it where it is. Oh, no, they called a foul. Called a foul on Jones.
Well, that's his fourth, I believe, Greg.
Yep.
That could be very tough. Now, one update on Daniel Gibson for the Texas Longhorns. They have taken him back to the dressing room once again. So both starting point guards in this game are out of the contest with injury. AC Law for A&M. No, he's back on the floor right here. So Gibson out for the Longhorns.
I'm pretty sure that AC was just a cramp. It looked like a calf cramp, but they worked out. They gave him some water, and he's back in there.
Well, that will certainly make a difference because they were not the same team with him out of the game. Three straight possessions. They did not look near as comfortable.
This helps. He can run the show, or he can score. And he scores. He can do both. It's 50-33, and a nice hanging jumper.
Well, that's P.J. Tucker's first two of the second half after getting 10 in the first 20 minutes of action. Nice job in transition by the Longhorns. That's the way they like to run. That's what they've got to do to make things happen.
AC Law is 20 points, 9 for 12 from the field. Jones dumps it inside, and we have a holding foul, or a pushing foul on Sid Harris.
good job right there. I believe that was Big Joe Jones trying to kick it down to Antoine Wright. That's tough to guard. Yep, there's the freshman trying to get it into their scoring leader, the 6'7 junior, Antoine Wright.
Full shot clock with 9:57 to go in the half and game. The Aggies have the basketball with a 15-point lead. A.C. Law. Right.
Texas in the 2-3 zone, coming off the out-of-bounds play under the bucket. Texas A&M wisely taking time off the clock. They need to be patient with a good shot against the zone. Chris Walker running the baseline.
They go into right in the post. It's short. And the rebound comes down to Aldridge for Texas. And now it's going to be pushed up by Polino, who tries to throw it into Klotz, but it's knocked out of bounds. Will be Texas basketball.
Well, the Longhorns can cut it below 15 here, knock down one of their tray balls that they like so much, cut it to 12.
They don't get much room, though, do they? Wright is all over Harris. He hits it anyway.
Well, that's what they can do now. This is the Texas ball club, we said, averaging 86 per game. They can explode at any time. A&M did not have the pressure in his face that they usually do against the perimeter shooter.
Well, consider this. If the Aggies don't score with this possession, and there's a whistle, so that shot is not going to count because it was a foul on the basket, maybe a pushing foul. Wright's holding his hands up like he's in protest. I don't know if they called it on him or not. I think it's another holding of the shirt. It's an offensive foul.
Okay, watch Sid Mill Harris jump up here on this replay. You notice that I've bragged on Antoine Wright's defense. He did not even get his hand up on that three-point attempt by Sid Mill Harris.
Well, he picked up the foul on offense for the old shirt-holding trick, apparently. And now, if Texas pops in a three, it's less than a 10-point game, but Aldridge walks. Wow. 8 minutes and 51 seconds.
You know, Greg, we're talking about Texas not scoring a lot. Texas A&M's only scored 13 here in the first 11 minutes of action in the second half.
And seven of them from Law. That's no one else helping out. So Law says, I'll try it. I'll draw a foul. I'll go to the free throw line.
Now, I know Rick Barnes well enough to know that's going to drive him nuts because A.C. Law just took that ball the length of the floor, drew the foul. That cannot happen, not against a good defensive team like the University of Texas usually is.
There was Aldridge, the last line of the defense, who picked up his third foul. Now Law at the free throw line. 70% this year, he has not been at the line yet. All 20 of his points coming from the field. Doesn't get it down. He'll have one more. Last season, Law shot 76% at the line.
Texas A&M 10 out of 14 in the ball game.
21 points for Law, 51-38, 8:39. Klotz has to hand it off to Tucker, who cuts around and scores.
And all that was possible because Texas once again made the nice entry pass into the block. Got it to Klotz. He hit the breaking Tucker going to the bucket. Nice execution. Longhorns move much better on that possession.
Back down to 11, 51 to 40. 14 points now for Tucker. There's a lob in to Jones. He's double teamed and he travels as he loses his balance. The Longhorns have held their position and he had nowhere to go.
Well, Texas A&M has lost their focus right now, making lots of floor errors.
Turnovers up to 14. And Longhorns at 13. 8 minutes to go, and it's an 11-point game, but the Longhorns can cut it under double figures with plenty of time. And a holding foul on Leach against Tucker. And that's, we're seven, so we're 1-1, but we're going to have a timeout, I believe. Both teams will take a break. 7:54 to play with a couple of possible free throws to be into a game. It's 11 points right now.
Dallas, Texas, August 10th, 1945. Nurses are forced to subtract 28.5 ounces from the birth weight of Gary Blair because they cannot pry the regulation size basketball out of his hands. Grayford, Texas, November 23rd. 1967, Billy Gillespie is forced by his homeroom teacher to write, "I will not make my classmates run wind sprints for not playing aggressive defense at recess 300 times on a blackboard."
Thinking about selling your car? Come to CarMax before you go anywhere else. We'll give you a free written appraisal of your car, good for 7 days or 300 miles, whether you buy a car from us or not. CarMax, the way car buying should be.
Start your used car search at CarMax. We've sold more guaranteed quality used cars than anyone else in America. So if you want to know what a high-quality used car looks like, come to CarMax and just take a look. CarMax, the way car buying should be.
Hey!
Technology have to be so difficult? At CompUSA, we make technology easy. Easy to get, easy to use. CompUSA, you're on.
This can be a factor down the stretch, certainly. Pompey actually fouled out in the first half. But Wright has not been a factor. He's been in some foul trouble. He's only scored 5 points. Here's a guy averaging 17.7. Buckland has been in foul trouble much of the game. He hasn't even scored. And on, you see down the list.
Well, Texas has much more depth inside than the Aggies do. You might look for Mike Williams to come back in the game now if one of the Longhorn inside players pick up another foul. But Tucker has a chance now to cut this to a 9-point game. It's been a long, long time since this has been a single-digit deficit for Texas.
Well, one more and it will be Tucker with the free throw. Now has 15 points.
Greg, the Longhorns only had 7 field goals the entire first half. They already have 7 here in the second half with about 8 minutes to go.
And they went the first 5 minutes with none in the second half, remember?
Well, they've cut that 22-point advantage by 13, now only down by 9. I like Texas going to this full court pressure.
A.C.
Make
Long.
The Aggies work.
Looking for some cutoffs. Now he dumps it down to Jones, who was challenged and fouled by Harris.
Well, this is really surprising how easy AC Law is able to penetrate against the Texas defense. He's just been doing it all night long. He's getting the good kickoffs. Nice shuffle there to Joe Jones.
He'll get 2 shots. He scored 6 points in the game. And he's playing with a bit of foul trouble.
He's a 61% free throw shooter for the year.
He has 9 rebounds and 7 points. And the Aggies lead is back up to 11. Seven minutes and 39 seconds. PJ Tucker.
Well, you can be sure Texas is going to try to keep getting that ball down deep on the block. That's where they're having the most success.
There's the man, Tucker. Oh, throws it over Clark's head out of bounds.
That's Rick Barnes talking to P.J. Tucker. He said, "P.J., you had the opportunity to make the move." He was too unselfish on that play. He needed to go ahead and take it into the paint.
Yeah, Klotz looked like he was expecting the move. That's why he wasn't looking for the pass or couldn't handle it. 53-42. Jones.
A&M, as you expect, being very patient now.
Jones down low, over Aldridge. Hit!
Jones, that was a strong move. Jones is 1 rebound away from a double-double.
Aldridge, who had one in his last game, has it taken away in a travel and out of bounds.
Take a look at Jones using his strength. This is what 260 pounds will do for you. He's going up against LaMarcus Aldridge and Jason Klotz for Texas right there. Just up and strongly between the two Longhorns. This young man for A&M has a terrific future.
Taylor is short. The rebound, Jones. Well, there's the rebound. 10 rebounds, 10 points. 6 minutes and 40 seconds to go. 55-42. the fifth double-figure rebound game this year for Jones. Leach. Kirk, a little short, and the rebound off the clock. 6 minutes and 20 seconds. If Texas is going to get back into it, they have to probably put in a couple of threes. Klotz is going to work hard, throw up an inside shot, won't go down, and the rebound comes off to Texas A&M. Bobby Leach. Leach moves by Harris, blocking foul on Harris.
Yeah, nice crossover dribble there by Leach. You could see it coming. He caught Sid Mill Harris backing. Nice aggressive play by Leach that time.
Foligno is going to come back into the game. As we indicated, there are a lot of things that have gone wrong for Texas in this game. When I say wrong, they may have been caused by the Aggies, but they have gone wrong because in addition to the stitches that Gibson had to have, he's only 1 for 11 from the field, only 3 points. Buckman has only played 9 minutes in foul trouble and no points. It's 55-42. Texas with the ball back again. Taylor for three. No, that's the other problem. They have not hit three-point shots at all. 4 for 17. And that's been one of the Texas strengths most of the year. Well, all of the year, really. Kirk.
Well, when you go on the road in the Big 12, it's a whole new ball game, and the Longhorns are finding that out the tough way here tonight.
Kirk to the baseline. Over Harris, and Harris is going to be called again. The thing that's impressive about the Aggies, they're just challenged. They're just going right at him. A.C. Law was going right down the middle. Here Leach goes right at Harris, and Harris is fouled out, I believe.
Well, that's the Billy Gillespie philosophy. Attack, attack, attack. If you watched his teams play last year at UT El Paso, they did a terrific job of that, advancing into the NCAA playoffs. Let's take a look at Daniel Gibson getting hurt earlier in the ball game. He got hit in the left eye right there. You see A.C. Law making the crossover move. Take a look, right, a perfect look right here.
And he ended up hitting a jump shot off the baseline.
They have now determined that Daniel Gibson has a concussion and he will not return. That's a shame because he's one of the great freshmen in the Big 12 conference.
Well, he did come back to start the second half, and you would have to imagine that he was feeling something, and that's why he pulled him out. He missed all of his shots after he came back in.
Well, we've seen Daniel Gibson play enough this year to know that he's a pure shooter, and he certainly was not himself in the second half here tonight.
Harris returns from the injured list and fouls out with 5:26 to go. Kirk is at the free throw line. Kirk's going to score three in this game. He gets his fourth. He averages 9.3 points a game. He's a freshman in Dallas.
Greg, as we take a look at Kirk at the line, one Big 12 of score of interest to report. Texas Tech is up by one against Kansas State with 8 minutes to go up in Manhattan, Kansas, 61-60.
Paulino with a dribble drive, passes it back to Tucker. Tucker's fouled, and he'll go to the free throw line.
Good things happen when you're the aggressor on the basketball court, and certainly the Longhorns exhibited that right there. Continuing to draw fouls on the Aggies, and it also enables the clock to stop with 5:15 to go.
Which would be good if you were a good free throw shooting team. That's what's hurt Texas at times this year. And Tucker's at the free throw line. Antoine Wright coming back into the game. He's had a struggle in this game, but his team has not had as much of one as the Aggies lead it 57-43.
P.J. Tucker's one of the better free throw shooters for the Longhorns, hitting 71.5% for the year.
He had one stretch where he missed 4 out of 5, but now he's hit 4 straight. 57-44. Leach beats the pressure. Penetrates off the right. Three-pointer.
Yes! Right! Terrific job by Bobby Leach. They've got 2-point guards on the floor right now, knowing that Texas is going to do extreme pressure. 1-point guard Law throws it to the other point guard Leach. He makes the great penetration move, kicks it off to Antoine Wright. Take another look at it. Wright just bounced up and hitting the silky smooth three-pointer for the Aggies.
2 for 5 from long range, 3 for 9 in the game, 8 points and one assist and a couple of rebounds in limited play. And his team now has jumped the lead back up to 16 with exactly 5 minutes to go.